Thank you. So this is the Merkle High School Concert Choir, and we have a few selections for you. We hope to enjoy them, that you enjoy them. We're starting with a piece by Christina Perry, called Human. This next song was a big hit when I was in college, and was a big hit again, I don't know, in the late 90s or so. And we've done it a few times. Some of you might have heard us do it before. But that darn Progressive commercial just keeps on bringing it back. So it's I'll Stand By You by The Pretenders. I hope you like it. Thank you.
Needle in the thread, gotta get you out of my head. Welcome back. Our first song for this is the Berkeley High School Select Course, and our first song for the Select Course is.
Well, thank you.
Our first song is the Agnus Dei Canon, which features Eva Moynihan on flute. This next piece is based on a Robert Louis Stevenson poem that I honestly don't understand, but I think is one of the most beautiful things I ever read. It's called "And This Shall Be for Music," and I hope that that you find the words lovely. I certainly do.
Thank you.
One of the traditions that we have in this ensemble is every year to do this one piece and to ask back many alumni who are in the area who would like to join us. So could I have any alumni who are in the room come on up and join us?
Wow.
Wow. There's a heap. So, every year, you know, we do a festival, and we have alumni here going back to the founding members of this ensemble. And Olivia is now a colleague. She works at the middle school for a few more weeks. Then where are you going? D.C.?
D.C.
You got a job in D.C.? you can applaud. It's teaching and everything. She'll be teaching dance and theater. So almost music, but... anyway, so amongst these kids, we've got kids here who have sung at in Williamsburg, Virginia, in Washington, D.C. We even have one of the chaperones from Washington, D.C. Eva was in fifth grade. Fifth grade, she was a chaperone. Carnegie Hall, Disney World several times, and Williamsburg again. And... we've also done lots of stuff that wasn't festival related, but we do need to thank somebody here. Joe Moynihan. Joe, could you... Joe, would you mind getting up on the stage for a second and turning around? Pretty much the whole middle of the shirt for sponsors this year says Joe Moynihan. And he wasn't even on this continent. So, this is MLK by U2.
This year, we did the Disney Sings, and we have some posters up there from Kenny Rogers and from Disney Sings. We hope you have a chance to take a look at them. I know it's a little dark back there. We had some issues when we were down there. We performed in Epcot, and there had been a storm earlier in the week that had blown the fabric roof off of the location. So it was only about 83, 84 degrees, but it was a hot 83, 84 degrees. And we had we got on the stage, and it was extremely hot because the stage was black. This polyester does not breathe at all. And so we're performing, and we got to the end of our set. We're doing the last song, and I sit down at the piano, which of course has a black music stand, and my iPad is on it, and I started the piece. It's probably the most difficult piano piece that we have done, and about four bars into it, it goes black, and there's a thermometer on my iPad that says, must cool before before using again. So we got through it. Song ends extremely high in A flat. Not that day. We ended extremely high in A, so they were really soaring by the time we got to the end. But I do want to say that our adjudication form, when we got it back from Jerry Blackstone, who is the president of the choral school at the University of Michigan, and also wrote the book on male choral singing. And he complimented the kids on being such a good team that when something as catastrophic as this happened, that they were able to stick with each other and stick with me. And what a great job they did. And frankly, I don't think the audience had a huge idea that something gone wrong, except for maybe the look of panic on the kid's face. But anyway, I really just wanted to say, we won, we did five songs, which meant we had a total of 50 points we could have gotten. And so we had, is it 48.5? We got 48? 48. So, thank you. So we tied for first place, and it was a great experience, but certainly a different one than we were expecting. All right, we're going to do this last piece. Last week on May Day, we were asked by Mr. Shea here to perform at City Hall for the May Day event down there. And they specifically asked for If I Had a Hammer, which is definitely not a song I would have picked on my own. But it really came out nicely. So we thought we'd take the time tonight to do it. You know, this was a song was originally written and done by the Weavers. Lee Hayes and Pete Seeger wrote it. And, Woody Guthrie was a member of it. And Woody Guthrie, on his guitar, it said in big letters, "This machine kills fascists." And on Pete Seeger's banjo, it said, "This machine surrounds hatred and creates world peace." I don't have anything
like that. So I brought my tackiest guitar to play this. So. Yeah.